And now, your First Alert 5 weather.
Well, good Sunday morning in Colorado Springs. We can still see some wet roads from the light rain we had last night. Now, technically at the Colorado Springs Airport, we just saw rain, so no official snow yet, but above about 7,000 feet, give or take, we did have some snow accumulate, and that was mostly in northern El Paso County, Teller County. It's 31 degrees meanwhile, and we are sunny to start the day, and our winds are pretty light, so definitely a cold start. You'll need to bundle up this morning. I had a scarf and a coat. 31 in Pueblo right now, and you can also see the wet pavement here where we picked up just a little bit of light rain last night as well. So at least this November will not go down in history as having no measurable precipitation. At least we got a couple hundredths of an inch. Now in Colorado Springs today, I've got a high of 50. In Pueblo, I've got a high of 54. So we're gonna be right around average, clear sky conditions. It's definitely gonna feel more like the holiday spirit, a little cooler today, but sunny in typical Colorado fashion. So 50s are expected for most of the lower elevation zones up into Colorado Springs, but Monument, Woodland Park, Trinidad, Walsenburg, even into the mid to upper 40s today, quite cool. Through this afternoon. So in the Pikes Peak region, a mix of upper 40s and low 50s, like 51 in Fountain, 48 in Ellicott, 46 for Calhoun today, 45 in Woodland Park. Along the Arkansas River, you've got mostly middle 50s, from 53 in Canyon City to 54 in Avondale and Fowler, and then to 49 chilly degrees in Beulah today. Now in general, we're gonna be drying out as high pressure moves in for Monday, Tuesday. That's quickly going to be replaced by another dip in our jet stream, bringing cooler air in and a chance of snow showers. Again, most of those snow showers will favor the mountains, but we could see that here on the plains. But before that system moves in on Tuesday, we have a fire weather watch in place for the counties you see in this nice tan color. And that's because we'll get windy and our humidity will drop less than 10% for most of the region. And then fast forward to Wednesday, just the day after, we have a chance of some snow. So going through that first look at some snow totals, this is going to change, but we've consistently been seeing, at least I've been consistently seeing in our model runs, less than an inch up and down I-25, picking up a couple of inches possible into more of our mountain and foothill zones. And that will be throughout the day on Wednesday. So let's time out on the Super 7 Day, some of the top things you need to know. Pretty calm weather, nothing to write home about for the next 3 days in Colorado Springs. Then by Wednesday, looking at that potential of our next storm system. This will mostly be impacting us Wednesday afternoon and evening. This could reduce your visibility while driving at times, and mountain travel will be quite tough. Then by Thursday for the holiday, a high of 47, but it's going to take a while to get there. Our temperatures are going to start in the low 30s by the time we get to 10 o'clock. So for the turkey trot, it's going to be a cold one. In Pueblo, our Super 7 Day highlights fire danger on Tuesday. That's where we see a high of 70 degrees, and those wind gusts will be up to 30 miles per hour. And then by Thursday, for Thanksgiving, it's going to be a cool start for sure, but temperatures are going to be climbing. Now in Canyon City, we're looking forward to 50s and 60s in the 7 Day outlook. You're breezy on Tuesday, free of that red flag warning for now, but then we're going to get cool to the low 50s Wednesday, Thursday. And then conditions are going to be into the 30s by Wednesday in Woodland Park with snow showers possible. I have an impact 2 out of 5 for you with some accumulation.